Hi, my name is Victor Nhieu, and today I'll be showing you how to use Kies Air, which is an app developed by Samsung. Kies Air is an app that allows you to wirelessly sync your phone to your computer without the hassle of using a USB cable. It allows you to upload and download photos, music, videos, and other files wirelessly, so it's an easier way to transfer files rather than having to find your USB cable. Keep in mind that this app is only able to be used on Samsung phones and will not work on other brands such as HTC or Motorola. If you don't already have the app on your phone, you can download it from the Google Play Store as shown here. First, you would go to the Google Play Store and then make a search for Kies Air. From here, you can click the app and install it straight to your phone, straight from the Google Play Store. So let's get started. First, you will need to find the app on your phone and launch it. Then click Start, and then click OK when the caution window pops up. A URL will be shown, and you will be using this later on. Now you'll go to your browser of choice, and enter in the URL that was given to you earlier. Now back to your phone, an access request will be coming from your computer, so click Allow for your computer to be able to connect to your phone. So going back to your computer, your Kies Air will start to load now in your browser. So when you're in your Kies Air webpage, you can see that you can do a lot of things from inside of here. First off, there's a photos section where it pretty much shows all the photos that you have on your phone at the current time. You can download and upload photos to and from your phone as you want. If I were to click on the camera folder, you can see all the photos that I have on my camera at the current time. If I were to select one of these photos, it'll show a blown up version of the picture, and also I can download the photo straight to my computer. I can also set it as a wallpaper or just delete it if I wanted to. To go back to the main menu, I would just go up here to the top left and select my phone name. It'll take me back to the menu where I started. Next is a video section where you can upload and download whatever videos you want to and from your phone also. If I were to select the camera folder, it shows all the videos that I have that are on my phone at the current time. Next is the music section where it pretty much shows all the music that I have on my phone right now. If I don't already have the song or album on my computer, I can just download it straight from my phone. And if I would want to upload a song, I would just click upload and I would just use the file explorer to find the music file and then upload it straight to my phone wirelessly. Next up is the ringtones, where it pretty much shows all the ringtones that you have on your phone currently. If I were to want to upload a new one, I would just click upload and then select the ringtone from here. And then I could just set the ringtone as a default ringtone and that will be my new ringtone for my phone. Next I have the bookmarks section. This pretty much shows all the bookmarks that I have on my internet browser that's on my phone. I can just delete ones that I don't want or add new ones if I wanted to add a new bookmark. Next, there's also a file explorer in here that pretty much shows all the files that are on your phone at the current time. As you can see here, if I double click SD card, it pretty much shows all the different files that I have on my phone. If I were to want to drop a file to my phone, I would just upload the file and then it would just upload to the directory that I wanted it to go to. There's also a messages log that keeps track of all your text messages, and there's also a contacts address book and a call log, but I've minimized those for my own privacy. So to exit out of this application, all you do is pretty much exit out of your web browser and then you go back to your phone and click stop on the app, and that will disconnect your phone from your computer. And that is the end of my tutorial. So the next time you find yourself without your phone USB cable and you happen to own a Samsung phone, you can use Kies Air to wirelessly transfer your photos, music, videos, and other files without the use of a USB cable. Thanks for your time.